You're wrong. Usually I would appoint her for this, but since it's about the number of women, I decided to introduce to some and present to others some wonderful women. I am from the time of Rosa Parks, who sat on the bus. And today, I celebrate us. Us as in Harriet Tubman, an Afro-American humanitarian that made 13 trips and freed 70 plus slaves, which created the Underground Railroad. Then there was Fannie Lou Hamer, voting rights activist and leader, jailed and beaten until she bled, but it didn't stop her. Nothing stopped her. She was murdered at a gas station for going into a whites-only restaurant. Her motto was, "I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired." My friend Billie Jean Young, poet, actor, activist, and educator, winner of the 1984 MacArthur Fellowship, the Genius Award. She's been traveling all over the world presenting Fannie Lou Hamer, This Little Light. Leon Su, a former comfort woman, so-called because they were sex slaves. She was kidnapped at the age of 16. When she returned home, she was very shy and sad and thought she was the only one, but one day she met others who had gone through the same thing. So she decided to do something. She went all over protesting. She testified, even in front of the Pope. Her mission before she died was to get Prime Minister Abel to act like a man and admit the crimes upon these women. She was robbed of her youth, and all she wanted was an apology. Oprah, y'all know Oprah, talk show host, actress, producer, and an all-around woman. Rebecca Lee Crompton, first Afro-American to receive a medical degree. Shirley Chisholm, first Afro-American to be elected to Congress, first black woman to run for president. One of the famous quotes were from Shirley was, "You don't make progress by standing on the sideline, wimping and complaining. You do by implementing ideas." Bella Ann Lockwood, first female lawyer in the United States. Amelia Earhart, American author and aviation pioneer. First female to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean. She mysteriously disappeared while flying over the Pacific Ocean in 1937. Her famous quotation was, "Never interrupt someone doing what you said you couldn't be doing, that you can't do." Harriet Beecher Stowe, a lifelong anti-slavery component and author of Uncle Tom Cabinet. Marie Curie, Polish-born physicist and chemist, one of the most famous scientists of all time, and first woman to receive the Nobel Prize. Helen Keller, America's social activist. At the age of 19 months, she went deaf and blind. And what she did was work tirelessly on behalf of all the deaf and blind. Mother Teresa, the nun, charity worker, devoted her life to the poor. Indira Gandhi, first female prime minister of India. She was assassinated by her own bodyguard female educators and youngsters. She was the youngest Nobel Prize winner. She was shot in the head, but she still persevered. Wilma Rudolph, that track and field, won 3 awards. Maya Ham won 2 World Cups and 2 Olympic Games. Venus Williams, professional tennis player who was a former world number one in tennis. Her sister Serena Williams is the number one player right now. Lamar Bui of Liberia, activist responsible for leading women in the peace movement and shared a Nobel Prize, Peace Prize. Tu Yu, a Chinese pharmaceutical chemist and educator, discovered the novel therapy against malaria and is the first citizen of the People of Republic of China to win the Nobel Prize. The list of these women are phenomenal, but these are just a few. I leave you with, we women should have confidence. If you saw yourself the way others saw you, you would. You also should be a priority, not an option, a last result, are a backup plan. You are a woman. That alone